This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for tricyclic antidepressants and variation in the genes CYP2D6 and CYP2C19. This video will specifically discuss the dosing guidelines for doxepin. Videos covering the dosing guidelines for other tricyclic antidepressants can be found on the PharmGKB website and on the PharmGKB YouTube channel. This guideline was last updated in December 2016. Because tricyclic antidepressants have comparable pharmacokinetic properties, it may be reasonable to apply the CPIC dosing guideline for CYP2D6, CYP2C19, and amitriptyline to other tricyclic antidepressants, including doxepin. The guideline recommends an alternative drug for patients who are CYP2D6 ultra-rapid or poor metabolizers, or patients who are CYP2C19 ultra-rapid, rapid, or poor metabolizers. If doxepin is warranted, a dose reduction can be considered for patients who are CYP2D6 poor metabolizers or CYP2C19 poor metabolizers. A dose reduction can also be considered for patients who are CYP2D6 intermediate metabolizers. This is the PharmGKB doxepin pharmacokinetics pathway. A link to this pathway is provided in the description below this video. This video will first focus on metabolism of doxepin by CYP2C19, followed by metabolism of doxepin by CYP2D6. Doxepin is metabolized by CYP2C19 to dimethyldoxepin, which is an active metabolite. Doxepin is a tertiary amine with a greater serotonergic effect, while dimethyldoxepin is a secondary amine with a greater noradrenergic effect. In CYP2C19 ultra-rapid, rapid or poor metabolizers, there can be changes in the balance of serotonergic and noradrenergic effects, with greater noradrenergic effects in ultra-rapid and rapid metabolizers, and greater serotonergic effects in poor metabolizers. This may affect response or incidence of side effects. There are currently over 30 defined alleles of CYP2C19, known as star alleles. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 allele, which is designated as a normal function allele. Diplotypes of CYP2C19 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Note that as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This can include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C19 alleles can be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. Let's move on to look at metabolism of doxepin by CYP2D6. Doxepin is metabolized by CYP2D6 to form less active metabolites. In CYP2D6 ultra-rapid metabolizers, metabolism of doxepin is increased. This reduces the concentrations of doxepin in the body, which increases the probability of pharmacotherapy failure. In CYP2D6 poor metabolizers, metabolism of doxepin is reduced. This increases the concentrations of doxepin in the body, which increases the probability of side effects. There are almost 150 different CYP2D6 alleles, which are designated as star alleles. Each star allele can be assigned an activity value based on its activity level compared to the star 1 allele. The star 1 allele has an activity value of 1. This table gives the activity values of some CYP2D6 star alleles. It is based on the CYP2D6 allele functionality table, which can be found on the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. A link to this table is given in the description below this video. It is strongly recommended that you consult the full allele functionality table, as it gives examples of alleles with their activity values, as well as extensive notes and caveats that should be considered. Be aware that some CYP2D6 alleles have an unknown or uncertain functional status and should be interpreted with caution on a genetic test. As a result of the CPIC CYP2D6 genotype to phenotype standardization project, the CYP2D6 star 10 allele was assigned an activity value of 0.25. This reflects its significantly reduced function compared to other decreased function alleles. More information on the project can be found on the CPIC website. As this guideline was published before completion of the standardization project, the star 10 allele is still given an activity value of 0.5 in the original manuscript. However, the guideline has been fully updated in the CPIC database to account for the new activity value of star 10. This update has not altered the guideline recommendations. It is important to note that patients can carry multiple copies of CYP2D6. Reports in the scientific literature have described cases where up to 13 copies of CYP2D6 were present in a patient's genome. Alleles which are present in multiple copies are given the suffix XN, where N is the number of copies of that allele that are present in the genome. For example, a patient with the genotype STAR2X3STAR4 has 3 copies of the STAR2 allele and 1 copy of the STAR4 allele. The activity score of alleles that are present in multiple copies is calculated by multiplying the activity score for the allele by the number of copies present. In this case, the activity score of STAR2X3 is 1 multiplied by 3, which equals 3. Further information about CYP2D6 alleles can be found at the PharmVar website. The activity values of a patient's CYP2D6 alleles can be added together to give a total CYP2D6 activity score for the patient. The CYP2D6 activity score is then used to assign a CYP2D6 metabolizer phenotype to the patient. Note that genetic tests from different laboratories may not use this scheme to assign CYP2D6 metabolizer phenotypes. Because of this, the guideline advises that a patient's CYP2D6 diplotype is noted and activity score calculated before making clinical decisions based on this guideline. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for doxepin by CYP2C19 phenotype. Patients with a CYP2C19 ultra-rapid metabolizer or rapid metabolizer phenotype will have increased metabolism of tertiary amines such as doxepin. Use of tertiary amines should be avoided in these patients. If use of a tertiary amine is warranted, therapeutic drug monitoring should be used to guide dose adjustments. This is an optional recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 normal metabolizer phenotype will have normal metabolism of tertiary amines. These patients can begin doxepin therapy with the recommended starting dose. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have reduced metabolism of tertiary amines. These patients can begin doxepin therapy with the recommended starting dose. This is an optional recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C19 poor metabolizer phenotype will have greatly reduced metabolism of tertiary amines. Use of tertiary amines should be avoided in these patients. If use of a tertiary amine is warranted, a 50% reduction in the recommended starting dose should be considered. This is an optional recommendation. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for doxepin by CYP2D6 phenotype. Patients with a CYP2D6 ultra-rapid metabolizer phenotype will have increased metabolism of TCAs such as doxepin to less active compounds. Use of TCAs should be avoided in these patients. If use of a TCA is warranted, consider titrating to a higher target dose than for normal metabolizers. This is an optional recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 normal metabolizer phenotype will have normal metabolism of TCAs. These patients can begin doxepin therapy with the recommended starting dose. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have reduced metabolism of TCAs to less active compounds. A 25% reduction in the recommended starting dose should be considered for these patients. This is an optional recommendation. Patients with a CYP2D6 poor metabolizer phenotype will have greatly reduced metabolism of TCAs to less active compounds. Use of TCAs should be avoided in these patients. If use of a TCA is warranted, a 50% reduction in the recommended starting dose should be considered. This is an optional recommendation. The dosing recommendations for doxepin can be found in tables 2, 3, and 4 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of each table. Be aware that these dosing recommendations are for cases where higher initial doses of a TCA are warranted, such as in the treatment of depression. Recommendations for lower initial doses of TCA, for for example in the treatment of neuropathic pain, are given in the guideline manuscript. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for a patient's response to doxepin, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific genotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.